Have a seat. I believe the Lord's in this place today. Thank you for what you brought. Wow. So, Jesus is talking to the disciples about vines and branches. And in the Acts of the Apostles, we have Philip and the eunuch. And then John's letter talks about being perfected, God's love being perfected, that is brought to maturity in us. Vines and branches, we don't relate so much to that, I guess. We have petunias in our yard, no vines and branches, but same principle goes. Jesus was talking to the followers and disciples and said the branches need to be trimmed back to the vine so that new fruit will come about. Now, if you have petunias, you know that you got to snap the heads off the ones that got the little hole. I'm seeing some heads nodding there. See, you got to snap the heads off of what's been old so that the juice that's in the rest of the petunia will flourish, will make the other petunias come out. Jesus is talking about getting rid of some of the stuff that stands in our way, things that we've maybe gone astray, and trimming that back and being part of the true vine and bringing forth new fruit. New fruit comes out. I don't know about you, and I'm not going to ask for a show of hands, but I've been trimmed a couple of times by Jesus. Yeah, wandered off, did a little something, just a little thing. No, don't go there anymore. Get trimmed, you come back. Get trimmed, you come back. Thomas Dorsey wrote Precious Lord. Thomas Dorsey's buried about 30 miles from here in Temple, a little country cemetery out there. Thomas Dorsey wrote Precious Lord when? After he buried his wife and newborn child in the same grave. He was a blues musician. He got trimmed. Turned around. Wrote Precious Lord, became the founding writer of gospel music that we know. He was one of the first. Turned his life around, but he went through an awful trip. Lost his wife and child and sat down and said, Precious Lord, take my name. So what do we know about getting trimmed and becoming mature? The eunuch was riding along, and Philip happened to find him, Philip the apostle. Philip said, what are you reading? Do you understand what you're reading? He said, well, how would I know without a guide? And so Philip sat with him for a while and opened up to him what he was reading in the scriptures. He was reading from Isaiah about the lamb being sacrificed, and he said, this is the one who's been sacrificed for us, it's Jesus. Eunuch asked a very important question. Then, here's water. What's to prevent me from being baptized? The eunuch was ready. And Philip took him down to the water hole, whatever that was, a cistern or creek, and baptized him right there. Now, the good thing it happened then, because if it happened now, we'd say, well, wait a minute. We got to prepare bulletins. We got to find a book, place in the book where we do this. The institutional church has kind of made this a little bit more difficult. But the call in our society is still there. People want to know that there's more to us, that there is a Savior, that there is something that's going to trim us and help us bring forth good fruit to maturity that is of God and not of, well, all the other stuff that seems to be getting in the way these days. The eunuch said, what's to prevent me from being baptized? What is to prevent us from being the baptizers in the world? And what is the fruit that we're asked to bring forth? And how might we bring forth this fruit? The gospel today is calling us to take our turn at it, to be a part of bringing forth goodness in the world. John's letter talks about the love of God being perfected in us. Perfected in this sense, I think, means maturity. How can the love of God mature in us, like a fine wine back to the vines and the fruit? How can the love of God be matured in us? I think we've got some clues in this, and there's three that I'll give you, three areas where I think we give some fruit. First of all, in this congregation, we're alive with helping people around us. We'll reach out. We're reaching out to you all today. Bring you in. We've been fed, right? You did feed. Yeah. All right, good. Now the next thing you're going to need in a year or two is a job. Huh? You want a job? All right. Anybody working for a company that's hiring in the next year or so? Hold up your hand. All right. There you go. There's your target right after the church. We're part of the branches that are going to help you become the citizens that you want to become. That's why you're going to college, to become better citizens, to learn about the ways of the world. We're part of the branches that are going to welcome you to Atlanta. We want you to move to Atlanta. Set up a home here. Durham's okay, but it's not Atlanta. So we reach out. We reach out to people who are in need, too, who need a cup of water because they're thirsty, and need a hand on the shoulder because they're broken. They need food. You're part of the food bank. Part of the hunger bar. Part of what makes people whole, in Jesus' name. So that's one part of bearing fruit. The other part of bearing fruit is in the households that we live in. The partners we've chosen to be our life partners and the families that we're raising. It's that kind of work of bearing fruit in that, nurturing one another. Someone said to me, marriage is not a 50-50 proposition, it's a 100-100 proposition. Both have to put it in. That kind of fruit bearing nurtures the very root of our society and roots of our churches. And we can get along and getting along in here. That's easy, right? Okay. That's work. Getting along in churches. It's not just about trying to get along. It's about working out gospel values together. That's why sometimes it gets so tense in the church, because it's about relationships. But that's part of the fruit of this vine that we're attached to. It's learning how to get along with one another to a purpose that is God-driven and God's fruit. And the third way is the fruit within ourselves that we're responsible for in ourselves. And that is waking up in the morning and giving thanks to God that you got a roof over your heads and you know what you're going to eat that day. You got people around you that are counting on you, or you can count on. You get to midday and you say, thank God I am the person that I have tried to become, and please forgive me for what I did right after breakfast this morning. And you lay down at night and give thanks for all that God has given you. Yes. And in the midst of all that, you break open the Holy Scriptures and say, there's something here for me today. Now that's nurturing, and it's fruit. It's giving to yourself. Enoch said, there's water. What's going to be being baptized? All the unit needed was a guide. We're the guides. Order my steps, Lord. And I might be a guide. Order my steps that I might be part of your vineyard and bear the fruit that you have asked us to bear. It's that easy. It's that complicated. But it's that life-giving. Amen. Amen.